Yeah, I bought a new kerosene infrared heater. I've been using gas tank top heaters to heat my garage. And it's gotten so cold, it's down below zero. And while they knocked the chill off of my garage, they just weren't quite enough to get it warm in there. They made it tolerable, but I wanted a little more gusto on my heater. So today I went and bought this Remington 70R infrared heater. And if you're used to running a salamander, I've heard people call them torpedo heaters or ready heaters. Well, here's a ready heater, 55,000 BTU ready heater. And this thing, we can't hear ourselves talking in this garage when that thing's running. And while it shows up on the video to be kind of noisy, that thing's probably a third the noise of that ready heater. It's got a lot better fuel efficiency. The heat dispersion on it's a lot more even. It's just an all-around a lot better heater. Downside is you can't run a thermostat on it. You either turn that thing on and let it rip, or plan on turning it off and turning it back on occasion. My plan is to use that to get my garage up to temperature, and then I'll regulate my temperature with my tank top gas heaters. Once I'm up to temperature, those are enough to keep my garage warm. But this is nice because it'll bring it up to temperature, and I'm gonna say in a half hour. Now we're over at my son's garage right now. He just built this about a month and a half ago. We're going through putting up all of his OSB, wiring it, getting ready to put a workbench in here. If you guys have watched my videos, kind of doing the same thing in his garage we did in mine. This one's substantially bigger than my garage. We also put in ceiling fans, which helps keep that heat coming back down to us with this heater. So just a quick review on this. It's much, much quieter. I've seen a couple guys complain about them that they've had problems. This thing fired up without a... it didn't fire up on the very first time. It fired up the second time, and I heard that's very, very common. So I wasn't too worried about it. I'd done some research before I bought it. But yes, the second time I flipped the switch, it came right on. A little puff of kerosene right out of the gate there, and smoked a little bit, being a new heater. But once we got it heated up, let it run for 15 or 20 minutes, she cleaned up. It's pretty quiet, very clean burning. Head and shoulders a better heater than if you're thinking about one of these, like a ready heater or salamander, what a lot of people call them. If you're thinking about going that route, this is definitely the way to go. It's a little pricey. It's an extra 50, 75 bucks for a heater of comparable size, but it's twice the heater those other ones are as far as just how quiet it is. It's way less fumes. It's just a nicer unit all around. So I definitely give it a big thumbs up. Just a little quick review on the heater I just purchased. If you like this review, please click like and subscribe. Geekster Man 01 out. Thanks for watching.